This right here, this thing LG, this is how you do it. In my hands, in its mercury goodness, is the LG V30 Plus. A lot of people have been looking forward to this phone, myself included, and I've had a chance to play around with this for a couple of days. And I thought you might be interested in knowing some of the things that I love and some of the things that I don't love and some of the things that I think I could improve this maybe for the V40, I don't know, or maybe V31, because this is pretty good already. So before talking about the pros and cons, let's start off with the facts. First of all, in regards to its size, it is 151.7 millimeters tall, 75.4 millimeters wide, and 7.4 millimeters thick or thin, pick your poison. Let's talk about this screen. Look at it. Where are the bezels? Where are they? Where art thou, bezels? I think that you guys are gonna really like the screen because, first of all, it's got a form of technology called P-OLED. And it's kind of similar to AMOLED, but of course it is its own, I guess it's a proprietary technology, don't quote me on that. In terms of the screen resolution, it is 6 inches large. And of course you can see that there are no bezels. In terms of the resolution, it's 1440 by 2880, which again is a really high resolution, giving us a PPI of 537. Just to put things into perspective for those that don't know, if you compare it to the iPhone is what, 320 something. This is way above Retina. But that's not all. It also has Dolby Vision HDR support. So if you have any HDR videos, you know, Netflix has more HDR content online, you'll be able to watch it on this screen. That's pretty cool. Additionally, it's got Gorilla Glass 5. Now let's flip this over and talk about these babies. Now one camera is 16 megapixels at f1.6. We've got optical image stabilization. We can record video at 4K. And by the way, I should mention that the OIS is 3-axis. It's got laser focus. It's got phase detection. It's pretty cool. Now the second one is 13 megapixels at 1.9. And the thing that's special about this phone is it has the best, in my opinion, wide angle lens ever. And I'm telling you, it makes everything look epic. Take a look at some of these photos that I'm gonna be showing you. And I'm telling you guys, it's pretty amazing. Now, when it comes to the dual camera setup, a lot of companies have been going with the telephoto zoom. To me, I actually prefer a wide angle more than a telephoto. I guess just that's because of the nature of the pictures and videos, you know, that I take. But it's up to you guys to decide whether that's more important to you, whether you want wide angle or you want a telephoto lens. Maybe in the future, we might see 3 lenses so we can have everything. So let's go ahead and flip this to the front. We can see that we've got a front-facing camera. It's very normal and it is 5 megapixels. I wish that it was higher because I'm not gonna be doing much with that front camera. In fact, I wish that it had that 16 megapixel, wide angle. That would be great, especially if you're doing like vlogs and that sort of thing with your phone. In terms of storage, you can get 64 gigabytes or 128 gigabytes if you've got the V30 Plus. Now, people get a little bit confused. What's the difference between the V30 and the V30 Plus? They might assume that the Plus means you've got a bigger screen, but in fact, they both have 6-inch screens. The difference, of course, isn't storage, but you've also got a difference in terms of audio quality. You'll see in the back over here, we've got that Bang & Olufsen logo, and that's because they've got a partnership with them, so they got B&O audio profiles. Of course, continuing that trend of audio being important, we've got a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack right over there. And in fact, we've got Bluetooth 5.0, which is great because not only are we gonna save on battery, but we can also connect multiple audio devices at the same time. So imagine both of you have your own, two people have, you know, Bluetooth headsets, you can both connect and listen to the same track, which is pretty cool. Now, on top of that, we've also got a quad DAC, which means we're gonna have boosted audio, we're gonna have better sounding music, which, it's pretty cool to see that a company is thinking about audio. For a company that is thinking about audio, I'm a little bit surprised, LG, that all you have is this speaker down over here. I would assume that you would probably put them in the front. I prefer front-facing, front-firing speakers. V40 maybe? Dunno. I hope so. All right, guys, let's talk about the power. The power. Does it have the power? Well, it's got a Snapdragon 835. It's an octa-core processor, but it's not a true octa-core. In my opinion, this is what I say, it's got 2 quads. And most phones, by the way, have, you know, two quads. The first quad is 2.45 gigahertz and the second one is 1.9 gigahertz. The reason that we have that, this is just to explain it for those who are new to the world of mobiles and processors, is because it'll use the weaker quad, and by the way, 1.9 quad is pretty amazing, when it's trying to save power, when it doesn't need as much power like when you're gaming. So that's a good thing. Now, the one thing that I felt that was unusual is the fact that it only has 4 gigs of RAM. Then again, it actually does have quite a very light skin or OS theme or launcher on top of Android, which, by the way, is 7.1.2. And maybe it doesn't need as much RAM, but I always feel like with Android devices, you always need around 6 gigs. Again, that's just an opinion, and maybe it's because other devices have always, you know, kind of lagged. But so far, in the 2 days that I've been using this, I have not noticed any stutter, which I'm very impressed by. Now, one other thing that I wanted to mention as sort of a downside, I think it's going to be a downside for many people, is the fact that it only has 3,300 milliamps. It's not a giant battery. But then again, most companies, like even Samsung with the Note 8, seem to be going for around 3,200, 3,300. In terms of usage, it's lasted me a day. I haven't had any issues, but I just wish that it was around the 4,000 mark. I know that's like the golden number right now, maybe one day. Let's talk about all the other options that we get. First of all, I already mentioned that we've got Bluetooth 5.0, which is really cool. We've got NFC, which is really cool. We've got wireless charging, not only normal wireless charging, but also fast charge, which they say we can charge to 50% in around 30 minutes, which is pretty cool. We've also got radio. We've got, of course, Wi-Fi. We've got that fingerprint scanner in the back, and it is in the right location. Samsung, looking at you. So it is in the right location. It is a physical button as well, which you can push to turn on the screen. And of course, it is also waterproof IP68. Good. I like it. Thumbs up. Let's talk about the design as well. Look at this. This looks like an iPhone X and a Samsung S8 had a baby LG style, whatever that means. And look at it, it's just really nice. I like the feeling on the sides. Of course, it's a little bit curvy, so that means that it might, you know, feel slippery to you. I like the back as well with that curved edge. In fact, I really like the design overall, and I think a lot of you are gonna agree with me. Talking about the screen, we no longer have that second screen. In fact, we've got this big giant panel that has an always-on display. So maybe that's something that you don't need to worry about. But let me go ahead and turn the phone on. And you'll see that we've got this new little drawer that we can move around and we can place anywhere that we want, and it acts like that second screen. So this is their software alternative to what they provided us in the past. Now, talking about that screen, I also wanted to mention that I like the fact that it is flat and it doesn't have that curve on the side, that the screen doesn't curve. Let me explain why. Now, with the Samsung devices, which by the way, the Note 8 is a beautiful design. I love it. I'm actually using it right now as a daily driver. I just don't like the light bleed. Is that the word? So I don't like the fact that with that curved screen, it doesn't have a uniform light. So with this, because it is flat, I always have a uniform view, which I like. But even though that the screen is flat, the edges are still curved, and so when I'm swiping, it actually feels better to use. I like LG's implementation more. So in summary, what do I like and not like? Well, I love the ultra wide lens. It's really cool. I like the optical image stabilization, which is phenomenal, by the way. I like the fact that we've got a quad DAC and that they focused on audio. I like the fact that we've got fast wireless charging, as I mentioned. We can get to 50% in 30 minutes. I really appreciate that. I like the design as well. So I think they've done a lot of things right. What don't I like? I wish that we had more RAM. I feel like I need more RAM. I don't know if I do yet, but that's one of the things that I wish that we had. And I wish that we had a better front-facing camera. Now, while I'm dreaming, as I said, I want it to be ultra-wide. I want to have like an ultra-wide, super extra-wide angle so that I can do those close shots and I can keep my mouth close to the microphone so it doesn't mess up audio. And I want it to have OIS too. So it's, those are the things, you know, that I want to add to my dream list. What I also don't like is the fact that it's only 3,300. Again, it's not a big deal breaker for me, but I wish that it was more. In terms of the overall design, it's beautiful. I mean, I really don't know what I would do more, except for, again, remove even more bezels and have, oh, a front-firing speaker. So that's pretty much it. I hope that you enjoyed this video where I showed off the LG V30, talked about some things that I liked. If you did, please don't forget to give me a like. Give me a thumbs up, because thumbs are free, but they mean a lot to me. If you've got any feedback, anything that I can do so I can improve with my videos, again, let me know in the comment section below, because I want to improve for you guys. Again, if you want to see the latest videos, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you and take care.